glad we're alive. So let me give a formal welcome to everyone on Zoom, although we have been chatting nicely, sorting out technical issues and stuff as we have gathered. And a very warm welcome to anyone who may be looking on live stream, who may be looking on a little bit later via the YouTube channel. Good morning to you and welcome to our service of Holy Communion this morning. I'm going to begin to share some liturgy. And as that just happens, shall we just keep a moment or two silence? However we are able to meet this morning, we acknowledge we meet in the name of God, God the Father, God the Son, God the Spirit, God is one. And as we meet, we acknowledge again that the Lord is with us and we pray together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we say sorry to God for those things that we have knowingly done wrong, aware that he forgives as we do so. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So our reading this morning from the Bible is taken from the Gospel of Matthew, from chapter 11, as you can see there. Some very familiar words from Jesus. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. There is a very short reflection to accompany that reading that can be found on the YouTube channel, with the observation that actually surely we are all in need of rest and recreation at the moment in this difficult time in this pandemic, and that reading points to Jesus as being able to be a source for that. So you may want to just check out that talk on the YouTube channel to find out more about how we can access that rest that we need. So let us, however we are gathering this morning, proclaim what we believe. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him, all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So let us turn to our prayers of intercession, and Sally is going to lead us in those this morning. Sally.
Right. Blessed are you, Lord our God, for in you we find rest and peace. You call us to turn to you in faith and trust. Grant that we may love you and proclaim your saving power far and wide, and that we may live to your glory. Blessed are you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We give thanks for all who labour for the coming in of your kingdom. We pray for visionaries, preachers, pastors, evangelists, and carers. We pray for those who are dispirited by the greatness of the task facing them, and for all who are wearied by their work, or for those without human support, for all who work in lonely and dangerous places. We come with our tiredness and our weariness. Lord, we come to you. Give us rest and refreshment. As we come to the end of a difficult year, we pray for all who have positions of responsibility and on whom the burden lies heavy. Grant them refreshment. We give thanks for the scientists who have developed the vaccine so desperately needed. And we pray for all whose mammoth task it is to make sure that all who need it will receive it. Grant them the resources of energy, courage, and refreshment they need to complete their task. Lord, we come to you. Give us rest and refreshment. Lord, make our homes places of calm and peace. We pray for families where there is strife. We pray too for those who have been separated from their loved ones for months. We pray for those who have been on their own for far too long, and for those who have found making ends meet a real challenge. We give thanks for those who seek to bring them relief and comfort. Lord, we come to you. Give us rest and refreshment. Lord, we pray for all who are over anxious, for the depressed and the despairing, for all who are ill, and for their loved ones who can only wait and watch and pray. And in a moment of silence, we hold in our hearts those who we know to be ill or in any kind of need at this time. Lord, we come to you. Give us rest and refreshment. We pray for all whose suffering is over and are restored in your kingdom. We pray especially for those who have died recently and for those who mourn them. May they know your almighty power and the joy of eternal life with you. Lord, we come to you. Give us rest and refreshment. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
So we're going to share a sign of Christ's peace with one another. A little bit of liturgy just before we do that, and open up the Zoom channel to share that peace. In the tender mercy of our God, day spring from on high shall break upon us to give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
We offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace, everyone. Peace be with you.
Peace.
And peace to those on live stream, those who are looking on maybe a bit later on the YouTube channel. Peace be with you. So we come to our time of sharing bread and wine with one another. We recognize afresh, the Lord is here.
His spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love, you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ, you shared our life that we might live in him and he in us. He opened his arms of love upon the cross and made for all the perfect sacrifice for sin. On the night he was betrayed at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all. As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ, our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven, saying, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest." So we pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. However you are able, draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed in him in your hearts by faith. Thanksgiving. The body of Christ. The blood of Christ. So we say together, Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. In a moment, we will say farewell to those who have joined us on Facebook, on YouTube. But just the usual reminder that if you want to attend on Sunday morning, please drop me a line, give me a call to reserve your space. And again, just to say that the strong need, obviously, to hands, face and space within the church when we meet together. Other than that, you can join us on Zoom. Again, if you need the number, let me know. Or on Facebook, on YouTube. I think that's it for the moment. So farewell to you who may be looking on until we meet again. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.